calendar, and this is for the moon in Libra transit between the 22nd and the 24th of May. Now, this is a very potent time because we are going to be seeing Saturn station retrograde at 13 degrees. Now, if we want to have a look at the history of this, we're going to be going back to 1874 when it transited and retrograded over these degrees. It retrograded from 14 degrees back then. And then again, we want to look to 1668, where it actually retrograded these exact degrees from 13 degrees back to 6 degrees, okay? So, in those histories of 1874, we are going back to the age and era of like Claude Monet and Renoir, and we are looking to when in the Americas, when the Freedman Bank was foreclosed because the trust account that they opened to the emancipated American slaves to create a new future for themselves, it was discovered that there was a lot of fraud and corruption within that bank, and that bank actually closed during that time. So for me here in Australia, this brings the Westpac Bank to me to mind immediately as what was disclosed last year with their dealings and what they're involved with, you know. And if we go back to 1668, we're talking about King Louis the 14th, I think it was, and Leopold, and also like the French insurgents into Catalan in Spain. So that's why Catalan has its own dialect of Spanish, is because of that history, you know. The good news of this exact transit of retrograding from 13 degrees back to 6 degrees in 1668 was that the War of Devolution was, I guess, dissolved. It was completed with a treaty of the Aix-la-Chapelle between the French and the Dutch, as well as a triple alliance between, I think it was Sweden and England, as well as the Dutch. So with everything that we're seeing going on around the globe right now, and with us being basically, you know, extortion of, you know, if we don't do a certain thing in which we are being told that we need to be doing, we will be excommunicated basically and ostracized from society, you know. So this Saturn retrograde is going to be a very, very powerful time, and I feel that just looking at the Freedman Bank alone, I do really feel that we are going to see some really big foreclosures of, you know, out of nowhere. I feel that we're going to see a lot revealed. So let's get into it. This will be for Aries. We'll start off with Aries. This is going to be hitting off in your seventh house, which is ruled by Libra, your opposing sign, and thus Venus, okay? So look to see what degrees your sun, moon, or rising is for your natal and your progressions, and then you will see when this moon opposes such, and then you will know how to traverse this and what days are going to be most potent for you to use that opposition to your benefit, okay? So what messages, please, do we have for Aries? Beautiful, first card out, the Four of Wands. I believe this card came out for your last reading as well. No, sorry, that was Sagittarius. So the first one out was the Six of Cups. So perhaps there's, and the Knight of Wands. which is a card reminiscent of you too, being a fire sign energy, okay? So the Four of Wands, the Six of Cups, and the Knight of Wands. I feel, Aries, there's a returning to home. I really feel that there's a soul lesson there. Excuse me. And underlying energies is the Death card and the Knight of Cups. So I feel, Aries, for you with this Saturn retrograde in Aquarius, please check to see where Aquarius is in your natal chart, to see which house it's in, so that you know how this is going to be affecting you and playing out in your life, okay, over the course of this retrograde. What other messages, please, do you have for these cards for Aries? Perhaps you're connecting with soul family is what I'm feeling as well, Aries. If it's not a fellow fire sign, it could be, I feel like what I'm picking up right now, and the reason I'm pausing is because I'm feeling it's somebody from your childhood that you're reconnecting with. And with the Four of Wands being the first card out, I feel that it's like a returning to home, I think is what the message was that just came out before. I really feel that so strongly. And with the Death card here as well, this could be within yourself, as like a soul path, a soul journey, okay, with the Death card being the underlying energies. Can you please clarify that for Aries? Yeah, they're just saying that this Libra moon is going to really shed light on things for you with regard to relationships that you're in. And also it does bring to mind the Justice card, which is Libra, the card for Libra, and karmic connections as well is what they're flashing up to me with this Six of Cups here. Can we please have a clarifier for this spread for Aries? There it is. It's the Fool card. Can't make it up. You really can't. So it will be a brand new cycle for you. And I really feel that once you discover where Aquarius is in your chart, you will be able to work out what Saturn retrograde is here to teach you, what you are here to revise, because Saturn is the god of time. He's Chronos. He is not a very good dude. The history and mythology surrounding Chronos is quite brutal and grotesque, to be honest. And he is the hard taskmaster. Saturn is the hard taskmaster of the planets. So I feel if this is a returning to home, perhaps, Aries, there's going to be a resurgence for you during this new moon, okay? Pay attention to when the next new moon is, Aries, because the lunar eclipse is on the 26th in Sagittarius, okay? And that's going to be a flower moon. But the new moon, all right, that came up for you. But this moon in Libra transit, I feel, is going to have you renew a connection, either with somebody from the past, or, as I was mentioning earlier, a past aspect of self. And something that came up in your last reading was about you used to pray. So perhaps that's what you need to do, Aries. So I'm gonna leave it there. Oh, sorry. Underlying energies: Five of Cups, Ace of Cups, and the Tower card with the Ace of Swords. So as I was saying, there is going to be a resurgence of energies because you've got these two beautiful aces in in between destruction and healing, you know. So I feel that this Libra moon, oh thank you, of course, because Aries, you have Chiron in your sign right now, and that has not been there since the 60s. And that was well before it was discovered in the 70s. It was discovered in 77, I believe. And I feel that Chiron in Aries was, I want to say 66. So you might want to check to see where Chiron is in your chart, Aries, because I feel that's what's taking place right now, especially as the moon will oppose Chiron in Aries in this transit, okay? I cannot ignore the two crowns here, you know, at the top of the tower and in the Ace of Swords. So I feel that you'll be healing, heart healing here with this opposition, okay, Aries? So pay attention, Aries, to your degrees of your sun, moon, or rising, or your progressed sun, moon, or rising, whichever placement you're watching this for. And I hope that resonates. Please like, share, and subscribe. And check the description box below on how you can work with me one-on-one. So I'll move on to Leo now. Leo, this is hitting off in your third house of Gemini, thus Mercury. And I'm feeling for you with this Libra moon, it's more of a cementing energies, because they're in your past readings, there have been such big changes in paradigm shifts for you, as well as romantically as well, right? Big soulmate energy. Big also career energy for you guys, you know, and I just feel with this transit in your third, I feel like that it's all just going to even expand more, because Gemini is the communicator, right? You can't make this shit up. This is your card. The Sun card just came out. So if you have, okay, just bear with me one moment. I'm getting like four different messages from this one card. So Merlin's here straight away, okay? Like if you don't already know, like the boy on the back of the horse is reminiscent of Merlin. However, they're drawing me to the red feather, and the sunflowers. And the sunflowers, it's powerful medicine. It's abundant energies coming in for you, Leo. It's like, yeah, it's finally here, you know? Like, I can't believe that it's happened. And are you seeing this? Two of Cups, my goodness. So again, as I was saying, that's completely like throwing me, like just because it's like, I can't make this shit up. Can I play some another card for Leo? Just to complete this spread. There it is, the Judgment card. I'm laughing because, well, Archangel Michael's coming immediately, and he has been a lot lately when this card has shown up in readings for me, which is, until this year, quite rare. It's a divine gift, right? You called it in. The Ace of Swords is the underlying energies as well. So you know your path. You know your heart, you know your magic, right? And with the Two of Cups here, like if this isn't a romantic read for you watching this, like, this is confirmation of you becoming unified within of your divine feminine and masculine aspects, you know? Like, this is big soulmate energy, big divine counterpart energy, but it's also, they're not getting me off of the romantic side of things at this moment. This is you called it in, is what they're saying. And for those of you where this isn't romantic, okay, this could be a manifestation, this could be a career thing, like, you're aligning to that which you desire. Look at it that way, you know, if this isn't a love read for you. Like, this is massive glow up energy, as one of my girlfriends would say. Like, if you're watching, sister, I love you, I adore you, and I cherish you. This is just massive, massive, like, yeah, you're calling it in. Spirit's heard you loud and clear, and Spirit has made it abundantly clear to you exactly where you're headed, because your clarity right now, your clear cognition, is just next level. So don't even doubt it. Okay, I do want to pull a clarifier on this spread, because as well, because considering this is hitting off in the third house of Gemini, I feel this relates to like sibling energy, and we just had the Devil card come out, which I'm not even concerned about with this spread, because it's just highlighting that you should be paying attention to where Aquarius is in your chart for Saturn retrograde. And if you've jumped on the timestamp, please go and check out my divine announcement as well as the introduction for some information on Saturn retrograde. I'm going to ask for a clarifier for you on this Devil card, because I do really feel that they are telling me there's some illusionary energy going on. So can you please clarify the Devil? There it is, the Devil card, the Queen of Wands. Okay, so the message I just heard is, be careful what you wish for. And another sunflower, and also the black cats. Black cats are so powerful for me, like, and they've been a totem very early on in my journey. A black cat indicates that you are on your soul path, you're on the correct path for your soul, you know, and you can't make it up. Underlying energies is the Ace of Pentacles. So it's all divinely aligned. You've got the Five of Swords, the Nine of Cups, the Six of Swords, and the Lovers card. So if, as long as you stay out of your head, Leo, for those who may have heavy mercurial placements, or perhaps you have Gemini progressed energy, or Virgo progressed energy, realistically, for a sun or a moon, right? Or Venus, because Venus will stick around 10 degrees either side of the sun, if that's what you're watching for. What I feel here with this sword energy in between all this beautifulness here is as long as you can focus on doing the work here, with the last card being the Eight of Pentacles, as long as I feel with these cards, as long as you can focus on doing the work required to bring in the funds, you will be able to cement the shift that you are desiring. So please, I'm going to leave it there. I'm really not concerned about this Devil energy. No. with it being clarified by the Queen of Wands as well. If you are a witch, if you're a practicing witch, okay, this is just a side note. If you are a practicing witch, keep your protection up at this time, okay? I hope that resonates, and I'm going to leave it there, Leo. Thank you so much for being here. Please like, share, and subscribe. Check out the description box below and my divine announcement if you haven't already in the timestamp below. And stay tuned because I'll be dropping more free content here in the future very soon. Next up is Sagittarius. So Sagittarius, this is hitting off in your 11th house. Yeah, and we just had the Emperor card want to make an appearance there. Thank you. They're saying to me, Sag, with this Libra moon transit over in through the 11th for you, don't be so stuck in your ways to not allow anybody else in. Live in the gray area of life, like, because pragmatism will not serve you right now, especially with Saturn retrograding as well. So Sag, check to see which house Aquarius aligns with for you. Excuse me a moment. Okay. Excuse me. Aquarius has some messages for Saggy for the 11th house for this Libra moon transit. Oh, there they are. This four wanted to come out straight away. So, amazing. Four of Wands. Again, Saggy, this came up in your last reading as the first card. So if you didn't check out the Virgo moon transit video for your read, definitely go back and do that. Then you have the Eight of Swords, the Eight of Wands, the Hierophant. They all wanted to come out together, okay? And then the underlying energies is the Judgment card. I'm really picking up on the eight energy here for you, the Eight of Swords and the Eight of Wands with the Hierophant. And with the Four of Wands here as well, I feel that there's been a bit of restriction around the home. And as I said, please go and check out your prior reading because that was based, your Four of Cards, the Four of Wands came out in the same position. And with the Eight of Wands and the Hierophant, I feel that the only thing preventing you from manifesting that which you desire is you getting stuck up in your head about it. So with this Hierophant energy here, I want you to embrace the Hierophant energy because a really positive archetype and energy of this card is that you are your own guru, okay? You don't need to follow anybody else's programming, conditioning, or indoctrination, whether it's spiritual, religious, or otherwise. You need to really, thank you so much. They're just saying you really need to embrace your own magic, okay? Because with the Judgment card here as well, you've been, thank you, they've just said you've been hearing the call from spirit, you're yet to heed it. So please, I hope that resonates, Saggy. Are there any other messages, please? This Eight of Swords is really sticking out to me, guys. So what is getting you so stuck up in your head? Please check to see where Aquarius is in your chart as well, as I mentioned earlier, because this Saturn retrograde is going to be a really potent time for closeouts, okay, and understanding and learning lessons right? So can we have a clarifier for this spread, please, for Sagittarius? There it is. You got to trust your intuition. Nine of Cups on the bottom, as well as what I'm feeling with the Hierophant here. So the card that flipped out was the Two of Cups, which I really, really like that energy, because it's such a balancing out of your feminine and masculine energies, okay? And it's a really grounding energy, because we ground down into our center, you know, our center point. Yeah, if this is, I'm just getting another read here for a love read, all right, Saggy? So, if this is related to marriage, okay, or engagement, things like that, stay out of the Eight of Swords energy, okay, because the Hierophant can represent marriage as well, and Eight of Wands is Cupid's love arrows, and with the Two of Cups and the Nine of Cups presenting themselves at the end here, I feel, Saggy, that you don't need to worry about having to, like, to moving into this new chapter of your life, you know, like with Saturn in Aquarius. If you're maybe experiencing a Saturn return, you know, and these can be one of the most potent aspects and potent chapters of your life. A Saturn return is, it's almost like a second chance of being able to redirect your life into a more divinely aligned soul and heart led path, you know. So I'm gonna leave it there, Saggy. Thank you so much for being here. Please like, share, and subscribe. And if you haven't checked out my divine announcement in the timestamps below, please do so. And the description box will have links on how you can work with me one-on-one as well, okay? So thank you so much for being here, and have a beautiful day. 19 above always. Love you. Bye.